Good morning, everybody. I'm Sarah, the Real Simple Mama. I'm going to do a quick video this morning about three plants that you can have around your chicken run that love to just take the abuse from your flock. Hello, everybody. So I'm going to stay outside the chicken run this morning. So I can tell you about three plants that I've just had really good luck with around my chickens. They are chicken safe. The chickens like to eat them, but these plants are either ground cover or they're vines, so they will continue to grow and spread. And they do really well, like taking the abuse from your chickens as far as like pieces of them getting eaten or entire chunks of them getting eaten, and the plant just continues to come back, and I think they look great. So there's three of them. Two of them are vines, so we're going to talk about those first. And the first is this light green one that's just gone crazy. This is a sweet potato vine. And yes, this is a vine that is actually growing sweet potatoes down below the ground. If you choose to rip them up at the end of the season and you will roll them up like you're pulling up a carpet, and you'll end up with sweet potatoes. But the chickens love to eat these. As you can see, it's growing prolifically just everywhere. It's also gone all the way up here. Now, this plant died to the ground with the crazy winter storm that we had. If you remember in Texas in February, all of my stuff that was just out here was kind of left to fend for itself, but it's come back like crazy. So everything you see is from one sweet potato vine. Another thing that's amazing about sweet potato vines is that you can clip them and take sprigs of them and propagate new ones. So you can see the second example I'm going to show you. This is a purple heart. I've got purple heart there and purple heart there. And all of the purple heart that's all the way around my chicken run is all from the same mother plant. So that's another beautiful thing about the first two ones that we're showing. I don't know if you guys can see on that little metal sign that's up there, there's a lizard sitting there listening. So sweet potato vine is awesome. It grows really quickly. Now it looks just like this. There's not going to be any blooms or any other colors above the ground. It's just light green, but they're all over the place in Texas because they continue to come back. They're fairly drought tolerant and heat tolerant. If you're not sure what zone you are in and you're in the United States, I recommend going to usda.gov, and that will tell you geographically what zone you're in. And that way, when you're looking at agricultural stuff like plants, you can say, for example, I'm in zone 8. So I know what plants to look for. But the sweet potato vines will grow like crazy. They're beautiful and light green. There's also a purple variation that's a dark purple sweet potato vine. But if you're in a hotter climate, the sweet potato vines that are dark purple, they are not as heat tolerant, so they'll start to wilt a lot more quickly. The next one that I already alluded to is called Purple Heart. The other name for it is the Wandering Jew, but I always call it Purple Heart. They've got tiny little light pink or light purple flowers. And the shade of it, you could tell, like, this one is dark purple, this one's a little bit lighter, this one's like green. It depends on how much sun exposure they get. That will change the variegation a little bit. Now, this guy doesn't grow tall. They won't get more than like a foot tall, as you can see right here. But as you can see, I've got a puppy who likes to come up here. She's not chasing my chickens. She just loves to come up here and say hello. And so she keeps breaking pieces off. And either you can shove the pieces in dirt and ta-da, you have more free plants, or I throw them to the chickens all the time. You can see the chickens keep it clipped right along here, just like they've clipped the sweet potato vines right there where Flopsy is. So there'll be a little bit of a bald spot right in the range of those little beaks. But it doesn't bother me because obviously this plant is not hurting. So Purple Heart is another great one. That one's considered a ground cover because that one will spread horizontally. The third one might surprise you, and this one has benefits for your family as well as for your chickens, and it's spinach. So if you see this little blue pot here, and there's a thin vine, I'll zoom in here in a second, but I have another one in a blue pot there, and I have about four of them back behind me on my porch. Spinach is a vine that will need to grow upwards, and you're following that purple vine. It is going up here past my hibiscus. So there's one. And then the other one is over here. So spinach obviously is something that you can harvest. For people, we normally like the smaller leaves because they're tender. They're not as coarse and as thick and hard. But as you can see, the chickens love it. If you plant it in the ground, it will start to spread little pups everywhere. So it's another one that you can propagate for free and just split the plants. But the chickens love to eat it. There's no danger in it being around. Spinach, I do find it doesn't like the hot sun quite as much unless you can keep it wet. So it's kind of a baby, and then it doesn't like the soil to dry out. Hi, Lace. Oh, look, Lace is going to eat some spinach. You going to get some right now, girly? Get it, Lace. Uh-huh. But I love having these plants around because, I mean, everybody loves getting things for free. And if you can keep having more plants and just splitting and propagating more for free, that's awesome. I do plan eventually to have this stupid border, you know, because I have this concrete thing. I plan to have it pretty much solid, either purple heart or sweet potato all the way across. So there's purple heart all the way around here. That's just growing beautifully. I know everything looks really wild and we had more rain last night, so there's stuff everywhere. This is another purple heart that, again, we thought it died in the winter storm. It was dead down to the ground. And I mean, and I couldn't cover all of these little plants. So I was just like, all right, well, you know, see you if I see you. And now it's back and it's growing like crazy. So again, we're talking about sweet potato vine, purple heart, and spinach. Now I have a whole playlist here called Chickens in Your Garden that does the little marriage of plants that are safe for your chickens, how I put plants in the ground to make sure my chickens won't eat them, other strategies to be picking out the best things. But I mean, it's like a plant wonderland in here with them, with the ornamental trees and all of the different plants and the flowers and stuff like that. They have a ton of shade. They hang out under the plants when it gets hot. They have a lot more bugs now because there are, there's a lot more foliage for them to, you know, there's pollinators around all day. What, y'all? Jeez, they're like, quit talking and feed me, lady. The bonus plant that I was going to tell you about, or the bonus idea for more plants that can kind of take the abuse. The other one I was going to tell you about is rosemary. And this is a rosemary here in a pot here. I have another baby that I'm starting up on the porch. Rosemary is fantastic. And there are a lot of herbs. You should look into herbs with your chickens because a lot of them, pretty much every herb that I could think of off the top of my head has at least one benefit for your chickens and for you. This rosemary I've had in a pot for, oh my gosh, probably at least 4 or 5 years. I've had it as long as I've had chickens, for sure. And as you can see, they totally ignore it. And it doesn't need extra water. It's just super chill. Like, yeah, whatever. You can just kind of ignore it and forget about it. But then, of course, when we're roasting, when we're making dinner, we will come out and just clip some of it off. So, I mean, you could look at anything in the mint variety, anything that's lavender, anything that's any kind of lemon, like lemon balm, lemongrass. Herbs are another great thing for you to think about. Now, some herbs your chickens will want to eat. Mine have never liked rosemary, but mine will eat a lot of other herbs. And that includes other things that you might just like for your kitchen, like basil. But I would look into them too, because there's a lot of benefits to them. And if you could have it in a setup to where your chickens don't totally kill it, but they just eat a little bit off of it. Maybe you have it from a hanging basket, or you've got it up on pots that are pretty high, or you've got it like what I do. So it's technically outside the chicken run, and they can maybe grab a little bit. But the heart or the roots of the plant, the brain of the plant is okay. Herbs is another great thing for you to think about. And I'm planning, hopefully this fall, to be doing a lot more experimentation with herbs in and around here in hanging baskets. Anything that's lemon or mint will keep away flies. Theoretically, it keeps away spiders too, but I don't mind spiders. But there's a lot more if you have the time and if you're interested. Of course, there's no point in trying to put like sod down in here, right? They'd eat it and destroy it within like 2 days. But there are other plants that, as you can tell, a lot of my plants now, they don't even have any guards around them because my chickens are like, meh. So you can kind of just experiment, but start by some of the strategies I have in my other videos about having the plants outside the chicken run, or have them up where the chickens can't really access them. Let them just get a taste and see what they think. But largely, the work that we put in last year has really, really paid off. I mean, the plants are going crazy. It's beautiful out here. It's cooler in the chicken run because of the tarps and because of all the shade from the plants. So I hope this was fun for you. So there's three easy plants that you can have around your chicken run. They don't mind getting eaten. They will come back. They are tough. They can take it. So let me know what kind of plants and ideas you have. Put it in the comments.